Yeah, so one of the things we're most excited about is that people don't really realize that they're learning new concepts while they're playing the game. It's first and foremost a fun experience, and then they realize, oh, now I know orbital mechanics. So we're very excited about that.
Great, cut.
How'd that go?
I think that was really good. I think that went well.
Nice.
Maybe next time, let's make it a little bit more realistic.
So, fly a mission with a more efficient rocket?
Yeah, less boosters.
Less boosters. Okay. I think I can do that. I think I need help. Well, thank you all for inviting me to ULA. I hate to sneak in on your lives like this. What are you all most excited about when you're thinking about Vulcan Centaur?
So my favorite thing about Vulcan Centaur in general is that we're able to take the power of Delta IV Heavy and the 3 cores and able to do all the mission set that it could do into a single core vehicle. So it makes it much more cost effective to be able to do that mission with a single vehicle. For people that are familiar with designing rockets and different elements, different stages that go together, the Vulcan stage will get to a much, much higher altitude, velocity, energy state. And so it makes our con-ops for wanting to recover pretty different. There's a lot more energy you have to bleed off. So for our concept, we just separate the booster engines themselves, have those behind the heat shield. Those would come down and land and would recover that, which is the most expensive part of the booster.
For Kerbal Space Program, the way that most people solve their Delta V problems is by adding more boosters. That's kind of like the running gag with Kerbal players is like, you got a problem? Put on some more boosters, you're fine. And I came here expecting to hear that in real rockets, we care only about, these fine margins and being as efficient as possible. And then I look at the Vulcan Centaur vehicle and I see that more boosters is actually a thing that you do in the real world. And it looks to me like that architecture is set up so that you can actually customize the number of solid fuel boosters attached to the vehicle.
That's absolutely true, yeah. We refer to it as dial a rocket sometimes, where if you don't have quite enough performance with your 2-solid configuration, you can add on 2 more and make it a 4-solid configuration.
Is it hard not to just default to 6 is the maximum, is that correct?
6 is the maximum, of course. And so that would give you the most possible performance. For some missions that require that, other missions don't need all that performance, and so you're better off going with a more moderate number of solids and flying for a little bit lower cost.
That's a very un-Kerbal way of... So are y'all ready to fly some rocket ships?
Yeah, let's try it.
All right. So welcome to KSC. This is where Kerbals have situated their space program. I'm curious at first blush, what is the real rocket science impression of KSC? Does this seem like a plausible launch center?
It absolutely does, yeah. I think you've got the major elements needed right there.
Do you feel like maybe the launch site is a little bit close to some critical infrastructure? Well, Kerbals are not quite as risk averse as humans are. They want to be close to the action. This is where we build rockets. And the first thing we need to do, we're going to work payload out. And I think what I'd like to do is see if this vehicle can deliver a Kerbal to the surface of Duna, which is our game's Mars analog. And then I'm also going to attach a stack separator to the top of this thing. And then on top of that, I'm going to attach a packed inflatable heat shield, little bit of solar power. And then because I'm sort of excited about smart reuse, which is the thing we talked a little bit about before, if you don't mind, I'm gonna see if we can do that in our flight as well. We might as do all the fancy stuff all at once.
Please.
So I'm gonna flip a decoupler. This is not a direction I'm used to decoupling in. And I'm gonna put a little sort of empty payload bay down here. Let's see, so there's two things that we cannot forget to do. One of them is we gotta check our staging. We're gonna do that before we leave because this is the order in which things will fire. And right now what we have is the Separatrons blowing our boosters up the side of the rocket, and then those are gonna fly off on their own, and then many bad things will happen.
That'd be fun to watch.
We can also color the rocket. I noticed looking at the model outside that there's a beautiful flame graphic that is painted on the side of your rocket, and while I cannot do a cool flame graphic, I can at least kind of approximate some of the colors. And you'll be able to see beneath the rocket some exciting things happening, getting ready for launch. We're off.
So will you throttle the main engines down for max Q?
I will not, because I have a lot of faith that Kerbin's atmosphere is nowhere near as dense as Earth. You can see on the right side in our staging stack, it's actually tracking our fuel levels, and you can see the solid fuel boosters are nearly fully depleted. The SF is getting pretty low. Doing a little wobbling. Here we go. Let him go. Goodbye, y'all. Okay, we're looking good. I'm going to continue our ascent. You can see the curvature of Kerbin. You can see the Space Center down below. Looking beautiful. I think I'll just let this stage burn as long as it wants to burn. We'll just use up all of our first stage fuel and get a nice high ballistic trajectory.
Yep. That's exactly how we use our rockets, and you burn the booster all the way to depletion.
Fantastic. Am I correct that the orientation of the vehicle with respect to the gravity turn, you would have the two engines horizontal relative to the horizon, or would they be in line? Or does that matter? Maybe it doesn't matter.
Well, if you think about the upper stage flight, where we also have two engines, you know, we will roll that vehicle while we're flying in order to get the best link margin. So as we're sending telemetry down to the ground, we'll turn the antennas on the vehicle to point in a certain direction. So we're pretty agnostic to the orientation of the engines as we're flying, certainly an upper stage flight.
We got our apoapsis now heading toward 40,000.
So just my instincts here, like I feel like I really want to start pitching down range a bit more. Of course, so much that is dependent upon...
We just switched to orbit relative.
The gravity and the thrust to weight ratio of your vehicle.
Mm-hmm. And now we've got our Centaur upper stage.
So again, if we're flying this like a Vulcan Centaur, you know, you want to...
just go ahead and drop everything.
Dump everything as fast as possible and get that upper stage engine lit.
All right. So do you want to start burning now?
So it really depends on how long that burn duration is going to be, right? But I would want to do it so my burn was done by the time I got to that
apoapsis
point.
Let's see what happens. Here we go. This is why you play this game with real rocket scientists. It's already an improvement. Hooray! Okay. All right, we're doing it. Here we go. Okay, so we can really time warp like crazy. You can see Duna's right there. We're converging with Duna. Coming in hot. Here we go. So let's see how this goes. So I'm gonna separate this guy from this guy. Say bye-bye to our upper stage. Goodbye, upper stage.
That's
Here we go, quick saving. Entering the atmosphere of Duna. We are now in 3x time warp.
So notice your para-dune value is quite negative.
Very negative.
Pretty steep re-entry angle, or entry angle here.
Well, let's take a look. Yep, we're coming in pretty steep. We're gonna wanna pop off that aero shell, or not aero shell, what is this, heat shield? So I'm gonna pop it off, and then we're gonna have to get a little, this wasn't planned especially well. We're Kerbals after all. Something broke, but I think we're fine. Whoa, there's our shadow. We definitely got it close.
14
minutes a second. I'm going to give it just a little toot when we're close to the ground.
Of course, for maximum efficiency, you want to give it
it's not quite a large burn.
Yeah, a large delta V rising very close to the bottom.
Yeah. We did it. We're
stay
down.
Up, stay up.
It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. This is the Kerbal way of landing. All right, we're good. Yeah. Nice little scratch.
Appreciate that.
To his butt. Well, thank you all so much for helping me get to Duna.
This is fantastic. Thank you for teaching us all about this. This is great.
Yeah, it was a pleasure to teach you all rocket science. yeah, if you need any more pointers, let me know.
That sounds great.
Yeah, thank you so much for giving us your time. I know we ran a little bit over, and I appreciate you hanging out with us.
Yeah, this is a lot of fun. I appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah.